Vishwa, very good morning to all my dear students. So in our biology, we are in chapter number 4, that is animal kingdom. In our previous video, we discussed the four phyla, that Porifera, Nidaria, Ctenophora and Platyhelminthes. Now I am going for the remaining phyla today by the repeated presentation. Scalminthes, Scalminthes, that is next is Annelida, Arthropoda, Mollusca, Echinodermata, Hemichordata and Chordata. So these are the important phyla we are discussing today, and that will be the end of the chapter. So here Porifera we discuss, just overview of all the slides. Nidaria also we discuss. Some examples are very crucial. Then Ctenophora, Platyhelminthes, generally Tapeworm and Planaria, now it is a Scalminthes.
Then unit feature body
Examples, there is a earthworm, there is a peritoneum, leech, there is a segmented worms.
Body has 8 visceral mass and
respiratory system, they are respiring with their gills. strong, and they have a strong core, a rudimentary structure similar to notochord. So here notochord start beginning. So in the balanoglossus, there is a tongue bone. Remember this, this is a balanoglossus. There is a tongue bone and a sacoglossus. That is, you can say, the two examples from hemichordate. Now here, some characters at a glance you will see. Now last is a chordate, then V. Remember V are in the group of chordata. So here, it includes animals with the chord, notochord, dorsal, tubular, nerve cord, and the parietal gill slits. The notochord is a flexible rod located in the mid dorsal line between the alveolar canal, nerve cord in the embryo. So that you will see in the important phylum, that is the last phylum, phyla of this animal group classification, chordata. Now here the chordata classic characteristic, they have a body plan. Then notochord is there, dorsal hollow nerve cord, and the pharyngeal gill slits also you will see. Here two things we have to separate. First, chordata and non-chordata. Non-chordata and chordata, what is common? First, notochord is found in the embryonic stage, but in non-chordata, the embryonic development notochord is absent. Next, the central nervous system is dorsal, hollow, and single. But if you see the non-chordata, they are in ventral, solid, and double. Here it is single. Pharyngeal gill slit is present. In the non-chordata, it is absent. Ventral heart is present. Here dorsal heart is present. Chordata of postanal part, state is present, but non-chordata, it is absent. Okay, most of chordata and non-chordata. Now, here next classification of chordata. In the urochordata, cephalochordata, and vertebrata. Now, my dear students, we divide the subphylum, that is urochordata, cephalochordata, and vertebrata. So that we will see quickly. First, urochordata, that is sulba and dolichium. So notochord present only in the larval tail, exposed in mind, hermaphrodite type of animals. Cephalochordata, the head to tail region notochord is formed. They are marine, sexes are separate. Then vertebrata, in that humans we consider in that, then possess notochord during the embryonic period, and notochord is replaced by the cartilaginous or polyvertebral column. Ventral muscle, muscular part is there, that is why they have open, closed blood circulatory system, kidney for the excretion and phosphorylation, and pair of appendages and fins and limbs you will say for the locomotion. Now, subphylum, that is vertebrata. Here, now last we will see vertebrata in the agnatha and the narrow stomata. It is an agnatha, that is jawless and deep jaws. So here, cyclostoma, then cono, tree, chitrus. It is chondrichitrus and osteichitrus. Then amphi, textbook is only the way we can understand. It is textbook